They're backstage building a dam. Did you notice in that video, my much younger, skinnier brother was doing the interview with Mark after he won the medal. It still gives me goosebumps. I have not seen that video in some time. It is still very special. So we've started the night with an impact, and now it's time to present the award for Open Water Swimmer of the Year. That's right. These are the crazy people in the lake, no matter what time of year. And of course, we have some great success. Here to present is the CEO of Swimming Canada, Pierre Lafontaine. And with Pierre, we have a very special guest. Last August, she became the youngest person ever to swim across Lake Ontario. 27 hours, 52 kilometers, she raised tens of thousands, well, make it hundreds of thousands of dollars for Camp Trillium, a summer camp for children with cancer. Ladies and gentlemen, along with Pierre, please welcome Annalise Carr.
Wow, look at her. Fantastic. You know, we talk from inspiration to inspiration. You know, you're special, and we feel special to have you part of our family. So, you know, before we go to introduce the winner of the Open Water Swimmer of the Year, we want to make a special presentation to you, because you're inspiring a nation also, just like our Olympians. So, on behalf of Swimming Canada, on behalf of 40,000 swimmers around the country, we'd like to offer you this beautiful plaque in recognition for the great work you've done, for the inspiration you've done for this camp. I know you're going to tell us a little bit about your story, but, you know, we're so proud to have you with us. And on behalf of everybody here and on behalf of Canada, awesome. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Pierre. I can't believe only a year ago I was just a little girl with a big dream. Today, well, I guess I'm still a little girl, but I fulfilled my dream with the support and help of my parents, family, crew, community, and my coach, Lisa Anderson. I may have taken a little longer than I thought, but the wonderful support I had and with the strength God gave me, I made it through the dark, cold, wavy night on Lake Ontario. I also need to thank the caring people of Canada who have donated to Camp Trillium. My dream a year ago was to raise $30,000 and raise more awareness for Camp Trillium. But because of you, we have raised over $240,000. And Camp Trillium is no longer Canada's best kept secret. And now, let's announce the winner of the Open Water Swimmer of the Year. And the winner is Richard Weinberger from the University of Victoria and Pacific Coast Swimming.
Four men racing down to the wire for three spots on the podium. He won a hard-fought bronze in the Olympic 10-kilometer open water marathon. From Pacific Coast Swimming, coached by Ron Jacks, Richard Weinberger.
Hopefully no one heard the other part. So I got a redo. Cool. We also have something else in common. Not on?
James, fix this mic.
See? Don't you wish you could always have a redo? I was going to say, we have something else in common, and that is we have a fear of swimming in open water. Where we differ is, I don't swim in open water. You do. You compete in it. Tell me a bit, first of all, I find this fascinating about your fear and what it is about open water that even, you know, at Serpentine around Hyde Park, what makes you feel uncomfortable?
Well, you know, you don't ever know what's underneath you. The water's always murky, and, you know, who knows what creatures are underneath there.
Well, sometimes that's actually true. Was there not an experience once where you got a little closer to wildlife?
Oh, yeah. Ron and I were going down the Sumidero Canyon, and there was about a 4-meter-long crocodile with its mouth open, sunbathing. He said, Ron knows animal behavior, so no worries. He said, don't swim in the back of the pack because they like to pick off the weak ones.
Yeah. So, you know, it has its built-in advantages because it encourages you to be fast, right, to stay at the front?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Yeah. Tell me about the race itself, another proud moment for Canada. In London 2012, and that was your performance in getting the bronze medal, and just narrowly, too, just missing the silver by less than 2 seconds. Just tell me about the race and how it felt to you.
Pretty much the race was unspeakable. Like, there's no words to describe, like, the feelings I was feeling in the race. It was so huge, and I was swimming, and normally there isn't the biggest crowds while doing open water races. You're down in, you know, Santos, Brazil, and you're out in the ocean, and there's no crowds. So while I was swimming, there was all these people lined up on the shore, and I was like, what's going on? This is open water swimming, you know, not, you know, basketball or whatever. So, you know, it's just, it shows how much support there was from everyone, all countries, everyone who's helped me. Thank you very much, and, you know, it got me to where I am.
That's great. Well, congratulations once again on winning it. Richard Weinberger, Open Water Swimmer of the Year. And by the way, your coach, Ron Jacks, is the Open Water Coach of the Year. He sends his regrets, and we are happy to receive his award as well in his absence. Thank you so much. Congratulations.
Thank you.